Yes, hi everyone. My name is Olga Harbowska. I'm here as social media and outreach manager. And as you can see here, people, employees of the America House, we are not just doing what is in our job description, but we can do all different various things. That's why we are really hospitable house. And today I have my two colleagues helping, Hannah and Katrina. Okay. Hannah will be helping with the putting some of the vocabulary, and Katrina will give you a presentation about Florida, because today we're going to make Florida key lime pie. Well, in our case, we're going to make just Florida lime pie, not the key limes, because we don't have key limes here in Ukraine, but at least according to the research I've done, we don't have that. So, we'll start with probably with the recipe. Well, that's not the recipe. The key point about this cooking club is for you to write your own recipe, but you have the ingredients. Yes. So it's good if you have like a piece of paper and a pen to put the notes down. Just feel free to ask any questions you have.
Thank you.
And don't be afraid of speaking English. I'm not perfect as well. I might also have problems with vocabulary in general, but we are all learning, and that's a chance for us to learn something new and to try something new. Okay? Okay, I think we can start. In case, I think what we can do, the first thing, is just really briefly to go through the list of the ingredients, right? So do you know what are crackers? Crackers. Cracker.
Wow.
Or you can use biscuits as well. I'll show you the one we're going to make, we're going to use to make the pie crust today. But then we have sugar, regular white sugar. Then the unsalted butter. Butter. Yeah. What is butter?
Awesome.
Then we have egg yolks. Do you know what's that?
Yolk.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Then we have condensed milk.
Сгущенка.
Yeah, this is something that we definitely can find in our stores, right? So, сгущенное молоко. And then we have lime juice. This is quite simple. And we have lime zest. Do you know what is lime zest? Mm-hmm. Yeah, you need to grate it.
What is grated?
What is
it?
Cedra. We usually know as lemon zest, cedra limonu, but we can also have the lime zest as well. Okay? So before we start.
I have a question about cup. How much is cup? For example, cup 11, I don't know, and 4 cup. 125 grams, then 1 and 2 cup, 120 milliliters. Mm-hmm. What is mean cup? Mm-hmm. How much?
This is cup.
This is cup.
Yeah. So you might have different cups at home. So we'll be talking about the one that has approximately 250 milliliters. 200 to 250 milliliters.
Oh.
Yes.
Cup?
This is the cup. Okay, so the first thing you do when you cook, of course, that's you pull back your hair, or you can take a scarf, like to pull it back, so we don't have any hair in the food that we're preparing, right? That's logical. The next thing, you need to wash your hands. This is all really simple. But these things are very usually forgotten, especially when you're in the kitchen, you know, like you just do, oh, my hands are clean, that's fine. Anyways, it's better to wash them. So we have some people doing this. Okay, so Florida key lime pie. Well, it sounds like really interesting, and it seems like it's really complicated to make, but in fact, it's really easy. You'll be amazed how easy it is to make. So so far, so what you usually will start from is just making the actual pie crust. In previous, during the previous cooking clubs, we've been making the one from flour, and this one we're gonna use, what's that? You have in your list of the ingredients. What do you think? Crackers. Yeah, these are crackers crumbs. You can use all kinds of crackers, but you would probably need to use the ones that are not too sweet. And the reason why you have the next ingredient in your cracker crust is granulated white sugar. In case your cracker is not that sweet, you can add sugar, but since we're gonna use the crackers, I'll show you which we'll be using today. We're gonna use this kind of crackers. These are actually biscuits. Really easy to find in the store, not expensive, and they are amazingly really easy for turning them into a sandy substance. Okay, so that's the first ingredient that you'll need for your pie crust. The second one is, of course, butter. So what you do, you basically, well, you can melt it, but if it's really soft, and it is really soft, you can just add it the way it is to the crumbs. And you just mix it well. You might take, probably you would like to take a bigger bowl, so it's easier to mix it. And it's not going to the sides. And of course, it's much easier when you melt it. And you just, oops, it goes over the top. So you see, probably it's better to use the bigger bowl. I just decided to use it first this one, so you can see the consistency of the actual crackers, how it should be.
I have a question.
Yes.
How did you get the crackers into
the sandy?
Yes.
So what you can use a food processor, this tiny one, or probably you have a bigger one. And well, actually I can show it to you. So really simple one, not expensive one. Take the cracker or the biscuit in our case. Yes. And you just see. You're gonna be louder a little bit, but
magic.
Here we go. Magic. It's a magic here, right? So, but actually, if you don't have a food processor, you just take a regular plastic bag, you take the rolling pin. Do you know what is the rolling pin?
Scalpel.
Yeah. Rolling pin, and you just work it out really well. And it, actually, these kind of biscuits turn into the sandy substance really easily. So what we have here, we have butter, yep, and we have some cracker. Oops, goes over the top. This is not my fork, that's why. So you mix it well. The interesting about this crust is that you just mix it and it won't turn into the regular dough. Oh, we have some people coming. Butter, because I didn't take whole amount that is mentioned in the list of the ingredients. So basically it turns into this kind of mixture. So you see it's not the actual dough that you'll be using. But then, what you do, you take your pan, the one you'll be preparing your pie in, and you just put it in here. And you need to spread it evenly. This is quite easy, as you can see. You can use spoon or you can use your hand. It's up to you to decide. Just make sure you go to the sides so you have like not very high rim. And it's also up to you to decide how thick you want your pie crust to be. Some people like it to be really thick, to have a lot of pie crust. And some people like it to be thin and to have more filling. Is everything clear so far?
Yeah.
Good. Looks like it's not staying the places you're putting it, but as soon as you put it into the oven, it will become more stiff.
Is it necessary to have a glass?
No, that's the one that we're using. You can use any pan you have, like anything you are planning to cook in, to bake in, to bake in. So, I think it's too high here. So we just make it warm. Yep. It just takes some time to make it all nice looking. So as soon as you are done with this, you need to put it into oven for that is preheated about to 180 degrees for 10 minutes. And then you just put it aside to cool. And during that time, while it's cooling, you start working on your filling. I'll just put it here, so. For the filling. Well, for the filling, you'll need for sure lime. That's the one kind that we are using. The original recipe of the Florida key lime pie says key limes. Key limes are much smaller, so we are using Persian limes. Do you know what is Persian limes? Mm-hmm. What is Persian?
I don't know.
Persian. They are called Persian limes for some reason. No. Anyways, so of course you need to wash all of your limes and just to dry them. And then, what you need next, of course, you will need some zest. So you just grate it. And just make sure, probably for this kind of pie, you'll need 2 teaspoons of lime zest. So we just need a little bit more. You'll need probably to zest about 2 limes to have 2 teaspoons. Have you ever heard about key limes in general? Me too. But they do exist. And of course, if you're using key limes, since they're really small, you need tons of them to have the 2 teaspoons of zest.
Are they somehow different?
As far as I know, they are a little bit more tart than the actual limes that you're using. So when you're using key limes, you just need to be careful. It depends how tart you want your pie to be.
They are also yellow. The juice from the key lime is yellow instead of green. So the pie is actually yellow instead of green.
So now we have about 2 teaspoons of zest that we're gonna use as well. We don't need butter anymore now, for sure.
Can we use not just lime zest, but for example, orange zest or not?
You can try using it. Actually, I was experimenting a little bit, and well, since limes, they're not that cheap, I would say. Some stores have it about 99 hryvnias per kilo. Some stores have it 180 hryvnias per kilo. So they're quite expensive. So you can substitute with lemon. So what I was doing, I took 1 lemon and 2 key limes. The size I was showing you, about this size. So it works perfectly well for me. Of course, it gives a little bit like, well, the texture will stay the same, but the taste will be a little bit different because key limes, they are more sour than the actual lemon. But I think it still goes well. Okay, so the next thing you need to do is just to make sure that you have enough of the juice. And for juice, you need to process the juice from these key limes. So if you have the special equipment, the juicer, you can use it. But if you don't have it, there is a really simple and easy way to get the juice out of the lime. So before cutting it into half, you just need to press it a little bit and just squeeze it. It becomes really soft. Then let me find my knife. Someone took it probably from me before. Next thing, what you'll do, you need to cut it into half. You cut it into half, and then you take fork and you just spin it inside, and all of the juice will come out. Let me show you in a second. I'll just cut it into 2 halves, and I'll show you how it can be easy done. This is actually how I've been doing it here. Of course, I have juicer at home, but I don't have it here. So you have the lime and you just, you see, it's really easy. The same you can do for lemon. Do you know the history behind the key lime pie in general? So there is a legend that actually this pie was invented by some sponge fisherman. Do you know who sponge fisherman is? Yeah. So basically, sponge fishermen, they were spending a lot of time out in the sea, and of course they couldn't bring like all of the food they need. So they've been choosing the food that will stay without refrigerator for a long time. So they've been taking condensed milk, limes and eggs, and then they've just been making the key lime probably out there, because at the beginning it doesn't require to be baked, but then after people found out that it's kind of might be dangerous to consume raw eggs, it was decided to bake it for about 10 minutes. So here we have the key lime juice that we're gonna use. You see, it's kind of pale color, and it's really sour. I've been trying it, believe me. Don't do that again. Okay, so now we have our key ingredients, but of course we also need eggs. So now, you take a bowl, the one that you'll be making your filling in, then you take 3 egg yolks, Well, you can use the whisk, but you can also use your food processor, but we're gonna use the whisk. And you just need to beat it well so it turns into pale but fluffy substance. It will take some time too. Of course, it is much faster if you're using a food processor. Have you ever tried kilan pie in general? Have you tried it? Good. Did you like it?
It's great.
It's great? Well, are you Ukrainian?
No.
Well, yeah. Well, actually, it is really good. It is really good. It's just you can't eat a lot of it because it's sour and sweet at the same time. Am I right? Okay. So that's why people are adding some whipped cream on the top. So it just smoothens all of the taste, sour, and the pie crust is sweet also. So you have all kinds of taste there. So we are almost done with this. So the egg yolks are beaten. And then next thing, probably the most interesting one. This is the condensed milk. I think everyone knows it.
Mm-hmm.
So you just...
I even know how to drink it all with the help of two nails.
I think most people know here how to do that. And probably this is something that people really like here. And be always begging their parents to buy. Especially during the 90s. Yep. Something that was really admired by kids and was used to make waffles. So you just mix it well and you just need to make sure that, well, you actually probably would like to make sure that you have all of the condensed milk in there because we probably would like to have the filling to be really thick. And you mix it well. Actually, you don't need food processor for this. See? It turned into a bit like yellowish color because we have added yolks there. And now, this is where all the chemistry will take place. So at first you add the zest. You mix it. Of course, if you add some lemon zest, it will have some like green and yellow zest in that. It will look quite nice. I like it. Colorful. And if you use the orange one as well, I think it will add some rainbow to the key lime pie. Well, in our case, it's just Persian lime pie. Now, we have the juice. And you just need to pour it, not one, like at once, but gradually, and mix it. Your chemistry does it all. Mm-hmm. You do not need to mix it for a long time, just as soon as you see that all of the ingredients are mixed well, it's done. It starts becoming more thicker and thicker. You see? Probably doesn't look very nice right now, but believe me, it tastes really good. Done. Just probably, if your bowl is too small, you can use your spoon. Like for the whisk, you can use your spoon to mix it well. And it is done. So the filling is done. So you have your pie crust that was pre-baked for about 10 minutes and was cooled. And now you just add your filling into the pie crust.
I have a question.
Yes.
Did you put the sugar in with the crumbs?
No, we did not, because the crumbs that we are using are really sweet. So it depends what kind of crumbs you're using. If you're using the biscuits that I was showing, they're quite sweet, then like you don't need to put more sugar. It's going to be too sweet. But if you're using the one like Vershkovi, ones I've been using, the one produced by Svitoch, Vershkovi, they're not that sweet. In that case, I was adding some sugar. That's why it says optional on your list of the list of ingredients. So if you're using sweet biscuits, you can see that you don't need any sugar to add. And that's what I like. So, and then you send it into oven for about 10, 12 minutes. And you will see that it's ready. When it starts, like from the top, you will see like little bubbles coming. It means that it's ready. And then if you just move it like this, it stays stiff and it's not moving the filling. Then it means it's ready. And that's it.
And what's the temperature?
About 180, 190 degrees Fahrenheit.
Fahrenheit or Celsius?
Oh, Celsius. Sorry. That's 300 and something Fahrenheit, and that's Celsius, right. So, we'll send it into the microwave behind. We don't have oven here, but... Okay, now we have a small presentation about Florida in general for you to get the feeling about the people who live there, what's there interesting. And then after that, we'll have a like little party with key lime and pie and some tea, okay?
Hello everyone, my name is Katrina Self. I've been in Ukraine about 6 months now. My husband works at the embassy here, and I will be working with America House here shortly. So I'm going to give you a little presentation about Florida. It's one of the 50 states in the United States. And how many of you have heard of the state of Florida? Everyone? Okay, good. So I'm trying to make it as fun as possible. So. I want the first person to shout out when they know what this song is.
Jack Frost has lost his mind!
Alright, Tom, get the plane. Miami. South Beach, bring it in. Can y'all feel that? Can y'all feel that? Jig it out. Miami, the place where I come back go. Miami, the place at the sunset low.
Who knows who that is? Yeah.
So we sip a little
song. This is a long time ago. Who's heard of this song? One? Only one. It's one of my favorites.
Spanish, Spanish, Asian, Indian, Jamaican, black, white, Cuban, and Asian. Temperature, get to ya, it's about the rate 500 degrees in the Caribbean, you see.
titties with the hot mommy screaming.
Hi, puppy.
Every time I come to town, they be spotting me. Then they drop in, they ain't no stopping me. So cash in your door, we're blowing this fashion show. Pound for pound, anywhere you go. Yo, ain't no city in the world like this. And if you ask how I know, I got to be the best.
All right, let's do it at the end again. So no one's heard of this song except for one? Okay, that was very popular, it was probably 15 years ago. But I just want to show a little bit. So who's heard of Miami?
Most people.
Okay, it's a very popular and very international city on the southern tip of Florida. So, there's a lot of songs, movies, television shows. Normally, when you hear about Florida in the pop culture, mostly it's about Miami, and we'll get into that later. Florida is the red state over here, and it is, it's bordered to the west by the Gulf of Mexico. So this is the Gulf of Mexico here. To the north, this is Georgia. And anyone know this state right here next to it? Go ahead.
Alabama,
all right. And this is the Atlantic Ocean over here. You go over here, then there's Europe and Ukraine. And the Straits of Florida. And here, over here, are the Florida Keys, where we get our key limes. It is subtropical, meaning it's very hot most of the time. There are tropical, as I wanted to show you the video, because Will Smith talks about the rainstorms, so it's like the tropics. Palm trees, very hot in the summer. It can get cold in the winter, but it is extremely popular with most people in the United States for tourism because of its good weather. Okay, so a little Florida history. So Native Americans, like most of the United States, populated Florida prior to the 16th century, and it was first discovered by Europeans by the Spanish. The conquistador Juan Ponce de Leon, he spotted it in 1513, and he named it La Florida, or Flowery Land, and that's where it gets its name. St. Augustine, Florida, which is one of the cities, is actually the oldest city in the U.S., which is something I learned doing research for this. And it was established by Spain in 1565. So Florida was controlled by the Spanish for a very long time. Then they gave it up to the British, who then had to give it back to Spain before it became a state in 1845. It was the 27th state in the United States. Yeah, anyone has any questions, go ahead and ask while we're going through. The capital is Tallahassee, and the largest city, which I thought was Miami, is not Miami, it's Jacksonville, Florida. Florida itself is the third most populous state in the United States. California is the first, and Texas is the second. As I said in the beginning, it's very international, as you probably saw in the Will Smith video. I think he captured a bit of it. It has a very big Spanish culture, Hispanic culture, and a lot of Cuban influence. And so Spanish is spoken 20% of Florida, and the other 73% English. And then, surprisingly, it was new to me, it was French Creole, which was 2%. So the French inhabited part of who's heard of New Orleans? Okay, so there is a French Creole is a very big influence there, and they influenced that whole region. So it crept on over to Florida as well. So the economy, how does Florida make its money? And it makes a lot of money. It is the fourth largest, has the fourth largest gross domestic product in the United States. It made almost $750 billion in 2010. And it relies mostly on tourism. As I said, most people in the United States have been to Florida once, or have grandparents or family that go to Florida. Agriculture and transportation, which we'll get into in a minute. Okay, so again, Florida culture is dominated, very international, heavily influenced by the Spanish, Hispanic, there's a lot of Native American influence. There was a lot of wars. I was going to get into that, but not for this presentation, maybe another day. African American heritage too. Again, not going to get into that, but it's very important in Florida. It was part of the South and a slave-owning state prior to the Civil War, and can be found in its architecture and cuisine. It's mostly Christian, and there's a 3% Jewish population. Okay, so what is North Florida known for? So, Florida oranges. Most people in the U.S. would probably say that because of marketing, mostly. There's a commercial, you know, probably every hour about Florida oranges if you are in America and watching TV. And if you're drinking orange juice, most of the time it's coming from Florida. And orange juice in the U.S. is a big thing there. And we don't have all the awesome fresh juices that you have here, which I love. Mostly it's in a box that's been can store up to 6 months or something. Key limes, I'm not going to get into that because we already learned about that. But the Florida Keys are the islands, as I showed you, off the southern coast of Florida. And it's the southernmost portion of the continental U.S. There are a lot of artists and writers that flock to Florida, most notably Ernest Hemingway, who actually lived and wrote in Key West, so where he must have had a lot of key lime pie. It's also known for golf. Everyone goes to Florida to play golf because of the great weather. You can play nearly year-round, and it has a lot of golf courses. Auto racing and water sports. Let's see. All right, I was looking at the beach pictures for a long time because it was so beautiful. But Florida is also very much known for its beautiful white sandy beaches. Don't you want to go there? There's tons of different beaches. As you can see, it has a very big coastline. Almost the whole state is coastline. And so a lot of popular beaches, a lot of, who's heard of spring break before? There we go. So college students is a big thing in the spring. You normally get 1 week off at university, and even in high school too. But most parents won't let their kids go out alone in high school. But in college or university, you get a week off, and a lot of people go to Florida. Kids go to Florida for spring break. A lot of trouble happens there with, you know, alcohol and nightlife. And in the U.S., the drinking age is not until 21, so you know, some people drinking for the first time can get crazy. But it's very much known for that, and the beautiful beaches. So, as I said, tourism. Big moneymaker for Florida. It's a it was the top destination state in the U.S. in 2011, and between January and March of just this year, 28.4 million tourists visited Florida. So tons of beaches, very much known for that. Who knows what this is?
Disney.
It's not Disneyland. It's Disney World. Who knew that there were two of them? There's a Disney World and a Disneyland. Right, what was the first one? California, right. Disneyland in California was the first. And it did so well. I think Disneyland was built in 1955 in Anaheim, Florida. And it did so well that Walt Disney wanted a bigger and better resort. So he built Disney World, Walt Disney World. And it opened in October of 1971, and lots and lots and lots of families and their children visit Walt Disney World every year. It's huge. It also has golfing, theme parks, water parks, 9 hotels, camping, all sorts of stuff. So it is a huge attraction. Most families try to make it their goal to go to Disney World at least once with their kids. I went when I was very little, and I was scared of these animals, so I have not been back. who can tell me what this is?
Launching pad.
NASA, but what part of NASA? It's Kennedy Space Station, okay? So Kennedy Space Station is where rockets that are launched with humans inside of them come out of Kennedy Space Station in Florida. It's also a big tourist attraction, and it was part of, it was named after John F. Kennedy, after right after he was shot by Lyndon B. Johnson. So also big part of, you know, United States space program. And okay, so I want someone to tell me what this is. This is a TV show from the 80s that is very popular in the US and kind of changed TV for a bit, but I'm not sure if anyone knows that. Can anyone tell me what this is? What TV show? Long hair, white coat, big sunglasses, these two undercover police detectives. No one? They had the sexy fast cars. No one? No one can tell me what this is?
Miami Vice.
Okay. So Miami Vice. It was a television crime drama in the 80s, and it starred two Miami Vice undercover police detectives. It only ran for 5 years, which surprises me, because in American pop culture, this is something you should know. Everyone knows Miami Vice. During Halloween, you'll see dozens of guys dressed up as Miami Vice still to this day. It's normally the white linen suit, long hair, big sunglasses. It is actually kind of changed a lot of the way TV was, because it was early 80s and it brought in the music, the new music, new wave music. Who's heard of new wave music? Another big part of American culture. Who's heard of Blondie?
Everyone.
Yeah, there we go. Who's heard of Talking Heads? Kind of. So it's that type of music. It's the 80s kind of pop punk music. And this TV show brought in music and kind of flashy. It was when MTV was first starting off as well. And it was this new, you know, stop with the old sitcoms. It was this new kind of flashy music, flash drama, and it changed. And now most TV shows are similar to that without the big hair and the white suits, which I personally really liked. So, Miami Vice. Everyone should learn that because it is huge in American pop culture. Okay, and then lastly, so Florida, which is also known for retirement because of the good weather, the beaches, the golf, and the fresh fruit. Florida contains the highest percentage of people over 65 in all of the U.S. My own grandmother goes to Florida once a year for 3 months. A lot of people don't go to live there full time, but they'll go for 3 months in the winter to escape the cold and really get some beach warmness during. So it's very much known. You hear a lot about Florida and people being old there and retiring there and stuff. So important part of Florida culture. So, and the last clip was one of my favorite shows growing up, but.
Thank you for being brave.
Has anyone seen this before? I love the outfits, the 80s outfits, they're great. Alright, who knows what this is? The Golden Girls. So speaking of retiring, Gold, they're in their golden age, and another very popular TV show, Betty White, who's on the end here, is still doing hilarious movies and comedy stand-up in the US. But very, very popular. It's still on a lot of reruns in the US. But just to show that these four women living together, retired in Miami. Again, anything that's fun takes place. Who's heard of CSI Miami? That's the show. Okay. I figured everyone heard of that, so I wanted some old things. But yeah, most, again, if you're going to, in TV shows, movies, a lot of music videos, it's all going to be Miami, but surprisingly not the biggest city. So that's all I had. I wanted to show you mostly pop culture in Florida and a little history. Does anyone have any questions before we go back to our key lime pie?
There's just one comment about Miami Vice. It's just this generation knows more Miami Vice with Colin Farrell and Jamie Foxx, you know, the last one. Those contemporary versions. That's why no one could recognize the first version of Miami Vice.
Yeah, probably. That's a good point. But yeah, it's again.
Some of the slices are probably thin. It's because we have more people that registered actually, so sorry for that. But we know how to share, right?
Yes. Thank you.